So we're going to be creating a blog in this website that's currently existing called Blitz. This is the landing page we made in the No-Code MBA Webflow landing page tutorial. If you ever want to walk through that, that's sort of where we're kind of jumping off from with this walkthrough. So starting from the designer, you can find the collection with this icon here. This is the CMS icon. It looks like two little coins. And if I click into this, this is sort of where all of our CMS collections are going to live. If you look in, you can see we already have one for testimonials, but I'm going to go ahead and add a new collection using this button right here, create a new collection. So when this opens up, the first thing you'll notice is we can actually start from a template. There's a bunch of different kind of collection templates that you can start with, blog post, authors, categories, projects, etc., etc. So we'll actually start from a blog post template, and you can see that that populates a bunch of kind of fields all ready to go for us. Well, we've got the collection name. This is what will show up on the side and all throughout our site. And then the second thing below it is the collection URL. So for each collection item, they'll all have their own unique slug or URL, but they'll always have this piece of the URL before it. So your website slash blog slash post slash article, whatever you want to make it, we'll keep it post for now. And then going on down, we can see that there is two fields that are always required. That is the name, whatever the name of the blog post is going to be, and then our slug. So that's the URL that's coming afterwards right here. So we definitely have to have those two fields. And then everything else we can edit. You'll see we get 60 fields. We've already got these. So we're just going to go through and see which ones of these we need and what we need to add. So we already have our blog title. We do need blog body. That's going to be a rich text field. If you click into these, you can see that you can have your label, your help text. Help text appears right below the title when a client is filling out a CMS item. So if you need them to fill something out a certain way, like, hey, make sure that this is below, you know, 100 kilobytes, or just explaining to them like this one, that it's just a smaller version of the blog post image, that's where this would go. And then there's also some min character, max character, and also a little required field. Like if you should not be making a post without the blog body, that is important. I'll leave this off just since we're testing and keep on going through. I can hit save here. So next we have post summary. So this one is a summary of the blog post that appears on the blog grid. I think we'll keep that. I think that'll be helpful to have. The next thing you'll see, we have a main image and a thumbnail image. So this is pretty good practice when you're doing a blog specifically. The main image is what's going to appear on the blog post page, while the thumbnail image is what's going to appear on the little blog grid card. And that's helpful to have them separate, because on the page with all of the blog cards, you don't want to be loading like a big image for each of those teeny tiny cards, because it can really slow down your page speed. So it's helpful to have two different sizes within a collection item for a blog post. So we'll keep both of those as well featured. So this is a little switch that you can toggle on or off if you want a blog post item to be featured. I'll show you how that works later on, where we can sort of filter by featured items in the blog. Next is color. I don't think we need color for this one, but if you wanted it for some reason, you can have it. So a few more things here that I would like to add is a publish date. So Webflow does have a native publish date, but sometimes we want to have a specific date that it is reading on the site that is easier to manipulate. Because whatever day you publish this, that's what it will be. But if you want to have a little bit more granular control over it, you can have your publish date field. I forget if it lets you use this title. Sometimes it doesn't. Okay, so we're good. So we've got our publish date, and then I'm going to also add another plain text for author so that we can add in an author's name here. So this is a pretty good starting place. I'm going to go ahead and hit create collection. So we have zero posts in our collection right now. We will be able to add some sample ones here later on, but I want to show you that after I added this in, we also got a new page in our CMS collection pages folder here in our pages panel. So anytime you add a new collection, it'll automatically generate a post template for you. So this is where all of our blog post pages are going to go, and this is where we'll work from when we need to add our post page in here. There is something else I want to add to our blog posts, though, and that is categories for blog posts. If I go in here, you can see we could add in an option, so we could have different options for different categories, but kind of the best way to do it is by a multi-reference field. But multi-reference lets you have your own pages for categories, which is really great for kind of scaling later on if you want to have just different SEO pages for different blog categories. So what I'll do is I'll save the changes here. I just hit new collection, and I'm just going to click categories here. So it gives us kind of an auto collection name, URL, name slug. I actually don't need all of these fields for now. I really just want to have the collection for the name, the slug, so that I can reference categories within my blog post so we can filter by them. So I'm going to hit create collection, and I'm just going to add a couple categories in here. Or maybe we'll just do four, because I can't think of another one. So we'll go back to blog posts. And now here, if I want to edit again, I can just hit the gear icon. And I'll go down to add field, multi-reference. So this would be if I want a blog post to be both like news and culture. So we could do both that way. I'm going to add that in just so that we can see it. But you could also do just a single reference. So there would just be one for each. But multi-reference, we'll do that for now, just to show you guys what it looks like. And this will be categories. And then we'll reference categories. And I'll save this here. So if I hit save collection. So now our collection is set up, ready to go. I don't want to go ahead and import all my blogs right away. But what I can do is add in some sample items. So I'm just going to click add 20 items. And Webflow is going to automatically generate some sample items so that we can use these as we're designing the page. If I go in, you can see that we've got a bunch of dummy content in here. We've got our main image, thumbnail, and we've also got categories on some of these as well that are automatically picked by the system here. One other thing, I've created blog posts and categories over here, but let's say for this initial build, we don't want the categories to have its own page yet. Let's say we're saving that for later, or it's just sort of a collection we're using to reference things. What we can do is have this template page not published, so it doesn't show on the site. So by default, all the collection pages publish, but I can toggle this off to prevent the item pages from being published. So that's all good. We have our collection. We've also got content inside of our blog post. So we're going to go ahead and move on to creating our blog post page.
If you found this video useful and want to learn more, be sure to check out our complete guide to Webflow tutorial. It provides comprehensive tutorials and expert guidance to help you build professional grade websites, and also has courses on other no-code tools. And if you haven't done so already, or if you're new here, subscribe to the channel for more content like this, share it with a friend, and if you have any questions, leave a comment below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.